everyone. So this is the third installment of my experiences in Haiti. For those who don't know me, because I'm going to post that on different platforms on Facebook, I am working on a UNWTO project to develop excursions with a group of local guides in Jacmel, that's in the south of Haiti. So I thought that what I would do would be to share some of the experiences that I have encountered. I actually started the training a couple of days ago only, so it's all very new. But already I'm kind of facing some really interesting challenges. I think the first thing that I have to do is that if you do that kind of work, then you really cannot make any assumptions. The first question I had on the first day was, why are clients a priority in tourism? Which kind of threw me a little bit. So I really had to actually say that there are things that can be discussed and things that cannot be discussed. But it was interesting that I actually was asked the question in the first instance. But at least I was asked the question, which is really important. I guess as well, you know, I'm doing the training in French, so the majority of the participants speak French. There is one person who doesn't speak French, understands it, but speaks only English. And you would think that by using the same words in the same language, people would understand each other, but that's not at all the case. So I'm finding out that they are not understanding the concept that I am mentioning, not the words. Now tonight what I decided was to actually do it outside so you can get the noise sound. I have the pleasure of living in a guest house where we have two dogs. That's part of the pleasure. And you can hear the cow. And here we are. So what I have to do is really make sure that I explain everything and then ask, you know, again, have you understood and what have you understood? So it's really reformulating everything. So there is no kind of assumption that because you speak the same language, you understand each other whatsoever. So that's also very, very interesting. I think, you know, on the French kind of theme, I guess I have forgotten how on French in certain ways I have become. Really there is this kind of questioning here of why and why and why. And people expect some kind of philosophical explanation of why things happen the way they do. I don't know, because they want to find all these explanations, they have a tendency to also overcomplicate things. I mean, and they don't see the kind of literal meaning of a question. They always are trying to think about what there is behind it, where sometimes there isn't. So for example, we did a group activity today. What's interesting is that they really don't know how to work in teams. It's not something that they have been trying to do. It took about 5 minutes for the first person to take the initiative to talk and start the activity. But the activity is one that I do with, you know, or that I used to do with my students. It's called the Deserted Island. And you have a group. They are going to be going for 7 days to a deserted island, and they have to take one personal item that they can choose, and also they have to agree on 6 items that they have to share together in order to survive, you know, on the island for 7 days or 6 days. And the first question I was asked is, but why would you go and spend 6 days on a deserted island? So again, there is this kind of real questioning of everything. I really have to say no. This, you know, you cannot question this. This is the activity. You just have to get on with it. And the activity just happened like that, where I had to answer all these questions and say no. You know, we're going back to the question. So you know, all of it was very interesting. They learned, you know, and we did, you know, a kind of debriefing of how it all went. So they learned a lot about working as part of a team, and I'm going to do more and more of that. I also finished the session with an activity where you have to trust each other, because you have to fall back and someone has to catch you. So we did that as well, and they loved it, but I think that's really essential, because that kind of trust element is something that there isn't here. I think life is so harsh that they all fight to make a living, so to collaborate is not necessarily something that happens. However, today I had a fantastic meeting with the director of a kind of art gallery, and he totally understood the concept of experiences, and totally understood that, you know, I was looking to create workshops and also the kind of commercial value of this workshop to help the artists get some, you know, money in order to continue their personal activity. So he understood that there is a commercial kind of art that you can use to finance the personal art. But what was really interesting when we started talking about the workshops was that he didn't want to be paid. He said, oh, we're doing this because we like to give, and we don't think there is anything, you know, right in taking money from people. So, you know, I thought, what an interesting concept. We are all advocates of responsible tourism, and we all say that, you know, tourism is supposed to bring in economic benefits, and here I am arguing with a local person to say, please, can you take my money? Because the tourists, you know, will be able to afford it, and actually what we can do is use the money to give you money that you can give to the artists so that, you know, they can buy paint, for example, which is almost impossible to get here, and canvas as well. So yes, I think that's something that we never really discuss. Actually, I don't think we discussed it on the masters. But again, you know, amongst each other, is how you transform this kind of mentality of giving into something that they feel comfortable with, so that they can actually make money out of tourism. So here we are. I hope that was interesting. Of course, I forgot. My name is Carole Favre, and the name of my company is Small Matters. And if you want to know more about what's happening here, then keep posted, and I'll send you some more news. Thank you very much. Bye-bye.